You're not blaming me, are you? Being married to a prison officer didn't lose the contract for you. I'm sure of that. But maybe your dishonesty was the problem. Perhaps the Liefenbeckers felt they couldn't trust you.
I don't see any point in analysing why the Liefenbeckers decided against me, but I do know this. I am a successful businessman. Now, Meg, it may sound ridiculous to you, but if a businessman is a success, his wife doesn't need to work. And she certainly doesn't need to do a job that most people wouldn't touch with a barge pole. Now, part of my business life has to be socialising, and you have to be part of that. Now, being a prison officer, it's not going to work.
Is that an ultimatum?
Yes, Meg. I'm sorry. It is.
Hurry up and eat that. This will get cold.
Where's yours?
Not having any, I'm due at work.
Well, you shouldn't have gone to all this trouble then.
Well, I didn't want you saying I was failing in my wifely duties again.
I didn't say that.
No. You said I was ruining your business, which is worse.
Look, I was upset about losing the contract. I'm sorry, okay?
No, it's not okay. Just because things go wrong for you doesn't mean to say you have to take it out on me.
Look, it wasn't entirely my fault, Meg. If it hadn't been for your job, I wouldn't have lost the contract in the first place.
You lost it because you told lies.
Hal would still have recognised you.
Yes, but it doesn't mean to say he would have cancelled the contract. There's nothing wrong with being a prison officer.
No? Well, you don't see too many of them at the Victoria Club, I can tell you that.
It's nice to know your husband's ashamed of you.
Meg, I'm not ashamed of you.
Oh, we'd been through all this before we were married.
We have. We're both saying things we don't mean. Look, I'm sorry, business pressures get to me.
Do you think I haven't got any pressures?
Well, I know you haven't. I wish you hadn't.
All we seem to do is lock the women up, release them, and then wait for them to be sent back in again. It's hopeless.
Then don't do it.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
If you want to help them, do something useful like social work.
Oh, I haven't got the qualifications.
Well, what qualifications do you need?
Well, I'd have to go back to university.
Well, that's fine.
Yes, you'd like that, wouldn't you? Do you think you could cope with a university student for a wife?
Meg, I could cope with anything as long as it made you happy. The trouble is, neither of us are happy with the present situation. Now, you've already resigned once. Why don't you go back to university? Oh, lots of people are doing it.
I'm too old to be starting school again.
Oh, nonsense.
I want to take years. I want to do something now.
Well, isn't there some job you can do that doesn't need qualifications?
Oh, I don't know. Oh, look, I haven't time to discuss it now. Eat your breakfast, it'll get cold.
Well, okay, then we'll discuss it tonight.
See you later.
Now, where the devil did you get to, Lizzie?
I went to see my old mate, Sid. He was too sick to see me, so I went to see him.
And did you see him?
No, he wasn't at the home. He was visiting relatives, and that's when I got lost.
You mean drunk, don't you?
I went to the hotel to ask for directions.
So you didn't find Sid. Where did you spend the night?
At the home. They gave me a lovely, soft, comfy bed, not like the lumpy thing we got here.
Did the people at the nursing home know who you were?
No. And you're not going to have them up for aiding and abetting. They was lovely to me.
If nobody helped you, how did you get to the home?
On the bus.
Where did you get the fare?
From the woman in the op shop.
Ah, the woman who gave you the clothes.
Yeah.
And she didn't know who you were either.
Of course not.
Obtaining goods and money by false pretenses.
I told her I didn't have any money and I didn't.
Listen, Birdsworth. You don't know how much trouble you're in. Escaping lawful custody, obtaining goods and money by false pretences, theft.
What theft?
The woman's handbag.
I never stole that, I borrowed it.
You stole it. How much money did the woman in the op shop give you?
$2.
You wouldn't have got to the country on that. Where did you get the rest of the money?
I put the money on a horse.
With an SP bookie?
On the TAB.
Ah, which means you wouldn't have been able to collect till the end of the day. You're out in the country by then. Where did you get the money?
I forget.
Perhaps a spell in solitary would improve your memory.
You can't put me in solitary and I don't even have to speak to you.
What do you say to that, Miss Bennett?
I think you're wasting your time. Haven't you heard the latest? We don't punish escapees at Wentworth anymore. We make the place so nice they don't want to leave us.
So there.
Come in. Oh, hello, Meg. You're a bit early for the meeting.
Yes, I wanted a word with you first.
Oh, what about?
Getting another job. Well, the truth is, Bob isn't very happy about me working as a prison officer. It's the long hours, the shift work. Well, he feels... Well, we both feel we'd be happier if I was doing something less regimented. Social work, perhaps.
Would you be willing to go back to university?
Well, no, not really. I was thinking more of a welfare officer. Parole and probation? Or something still in the department. I was wondering if you knew what my chances were of getting a job like that.
Well, I don't know. I'm not sure. Well, I'll make some inquiries and let you know.
Thank you.
Come in.
Hello, Meg. Given the ideas much thought since yesterday?
Ideas?
The conjugal rights, the visiting scheme.
There isn't any such scheme yet.
Well, there's nothing to stop it now that Lizzie's back.
I would have thought that was every reason to stop it. Women walking in and out of this place when they feel like it. She practically laughed in our face when she was questioned about it.
Could we please get this meeting started properly? I've told the minister about the new scheme when he phoned to see what I was doing about the escapes, and he seemed to like the idea.
Well, of course he would. It'll make him sound good when he announces it in Parliament.
Yes, until something goes wrong, and then we're the ones who have to bear the brunt. Mm.
If anyone bears the brunt, as you put it, Miss Bennet, it will be me. The scheme stays. All we have to do now is to work out the practical details. I've been in touch with the Ararat prison, who already have a scheme similar to this. It seems that an indoor and outdoor visiting area screened from the rest of the prison is essential. Now, I suggest we use the shed where the garden tools are kept. We could easily put a retaining fence around it.
There'll be a lot of jokes floating about when people find out that the women are meeting their husbands in the garden shed.
I'm not interested in jokes. Mrs. Morris, you seem to be the only one who's not actively opposed to this scheme. Could you arrange to have the shed emptied and redecorated?
Right. How much do we have to spend?
None at all. The women will have to do everything themselves.
They're not going to like that.
Too bad. If they want this scheme, they're going to have to work for it.
Precisely, but we'll have to be very careful. The women are always suspicious of a scheme that originates from us.
Well, perhaps if I spoke to them, I'm sort of the man in the middle. It'll sound less official coming from me.
Yes, very well. I'll leave it to you and Mrs. Morris. Now, what's next on the agenda?
Could you get the women together for me, please?
Oh, yes, of course. As soon as they finish work for the morning.
This is ridiculous. We should call a union meeting.
No, we can't afford to block this with the minister making a statement in Parliament and make us look bad. Our public image is bad enough already.
Well, something must be done. This place is turning into a...
Into a brothel? I wouldn't worry about it, Vera. I think we can safely leave this to the women to mess it up like they have every other scheme.
Forget it.
What do you mean, forget it?
Why should we bust a gut setting this thing up?
Because you're the ones whose husbands will be visiting you.
I haven't got a husband.
Well, that's only because you shot him.
Oh, shut up.
Yeah, well, I won't see Kevin either. We're divorced now.
Well, some of you must have husbands who'll visit you.
Well, what about de factos? Do they count?
I'm not sure.
Yes, as long as you can prove the de facto relationship.
Well, I can prove it, all right. We've got two kids.
Mm. Hey, what about getting our kids back in here?
Yes, as long as child welfare agree.
And there'll be no more censoring of the male?
Oh, well, I'll give you a hand fixing up the shed if it means I can get Elizabeth back.
What's wrong with you? You can only have Elizabeth back if the child welfare say so. And we can only have unsupervised visits and uncensored mail if we're good little girls. Can't you see it's just another way of keeping us in line?
I don't understand you, Bea. I thought you liked the idea.
Not like this, I don't. It's got to be the same for everyone. Now, I've got a bloke and he isn't even allowed inside the gates.
Well, I can't help that. If people don't stick to the rules...
Well, that's it then, isn't it? If you think I'm going to help this lot get their blokes in here into bed when I can't even talk to mine, you've got to be out of your head.
Well, I reckon she's a bloody selfish cow.
Will you shut up? Can't you see that Bea's fighting for the principal?
Oh, bleeding principal. She's just jealous, that's all.
Yeah, look, why should we miss out? Just because Bea can't have her bloke in here.
It's not like that.
Oh, yeah, you'd understand, wouldn't you? A bull dyke whose girlfriend's bloody dead anyway. I mean, you'd really miss having a bloke in here, wouldn't you?
Shut up, Chrissy.
Well, she's right. Why should we miss out?
Why shouldn't you? I've got to.
Well, that's not my fault, is it? It's not my fault he's divorcing you.
Wasn't my fault either.
Well, whose fault is it then?
I said shut up, Chrissy. It isn't anyone's fault. It's the system. You'll get your bloke in here when we get what we want. They'll give in.
You reckon they really will give in, Bea?
You heard what Andrew said. It's being announced in Parliament. They can't go back on it now. We've got to screw them for all we can when we've got the chance.
And what if it doesn't work?
It'll work. Davidson can't afford another disaster.
Well, I just don't see what Bea Smith's up to.
Well, I would have thought it was perfectly obvious. What isn't obvious is how we handle it.
Well, Vera did tell me something. Why was this Ken Pierce banned?